Hello, people of the internet, my name is Johnny and welcome back to Five Nights at Freddy's Virtual Reality Help Wanted. And as you can tell, there was no audio yet. Again, I apologize, I'm so sorry. I don't know how this keeps happening, but I've set a goal in mind and I've set a rule in my mind that every now and then I'm gonna take a break, take off the headset, and check to see if the audio is working. Hopefully, that'll allow me to catch it sooner, but we can only hope for the best. But I did commentate over the mini games that I did do in this video, so hopefully you guys enjoy that. So I started off with Fun with Plush Trap, and this was a very, very, very easy mini game because I already know what to do in it. I knew how Plush Trap worked. I knew when I had to turn the flashlight on, whenever I heard him moving around, so I beat this one fairly quickly. For beating that game, I was awarded L Chips. Chips? After Fun with Plush Trap, I moved on to Fun with Nightmare Balloon Boy. This one was a bit more scary, just the way Balloon Boy stares at you and laughs and says hello in his deep, nightmarish voice. It's very, very, very creepy, actually, especially in VR. But I managed to pull through, and at the very end, I got a prize. That prize being a balloon. Just that, it's just a balloon. And for a few turns I tried with the plush babies, but I was very unsuccessful simply because I didn't know where they came from. I literally only knew where some of them came from. I didn't know if they were in the vents, I didn't know if they were behind me, I didn't know if they were in the vent above me or to the next to me. So it was pretty difficult and I did not beat it.
I guess you forgot about me.
The next minigame I tried was Fun Time Freddy's minigame, and his was just regular FNAF 4, except you had to keep a close eye on Bonnet. And even though I did die, I did manage to get the hang of it, and it's pretty simple once you understand it. It's, again, just simple FNAF 4, but instead of Nightmare Bonnie or Nightmare Chica, it is Funtime Freddy. I did learn that he can hide in the closet, so I had to take note of that, but ultimately, I did beat this minigame.
Thank you.
even got a Butter for One candy bar after I beat it. I then went back and tried the Plush Babies minigame again, but I just simply cannot do it. I just don't know the route they come from, and it's very difficult to spot all three of them in pitch black.
I heard your call.
So with the Plush Babies minigame unsuccessful, I moved over to Five Nights at Freddy's 3 because it looked pretty interesting and I hadn't seen much about it, so I thought I'd give it a go. I was able to beat all four nights because I knew exactly what to do. I had played FNAF 3, the original game, many, many, many times before, so I knew Springtrap's route, I knew the best place to hide him, which is bouncing him in between Cam 9 and Cam 10, so I just did that. And my strategy throughout this entire thing is keep an eye on Springtrap while also managing the ventilation errors, or the camera errors, or the audio errors. The best part about Five Nights at Freddy's 3 in VR is that you can use both the ventilation repair and the camera repair and the audio repair and the cameras all at the same time. So you'll see me throughout the clips keeping an eye on Springtrap and occasionally running into the Phantoms, but I'm always constantly hitting reboot all systems because even though it does take a long time, it is worth it in the end because let's say I get jump scared by a Phantom, the reboot all immediately clears the error and I'm back to normal. So it is actually a very efficient strategy.
Ironically thought we'd have more by now. If we don't have something really cool by next week, then we may have to suit you up in a furry suit and make you walk around saying, boo. But you know, like I said, we're trying to track down a good lead right now. Some guy who helped design one of the buildings said there was like an extra room that got boarded up or something like that. So we're going to take a peek and see what we can find. For now, just get comfortable with the new setup. You can check the security cameras over to your right with the click of that blue button. You can toggle between the hall cams and the vent cams. Then over to your far left, you can flip up your maintenance panel. You know, use this to reboot any systems that may go offline. In trying to make the place feel vintage, we may have overdone it a bit. Some of this equipment is barely functional. Yeah, I wasn't joking about the fire. That's a real risk. The most important thing you want to watch for is the ventilation. Look, this place will give you the spooks, man. And if you let that ventilation go offline, then you'll start seeing some crazy stuff, man. Keep that air flowing. Okay, keep an eye on things, and we'll try to have something new for you tomorrow night.
Hello?
At the end of the first night, I get a Bonnie bobblehead.
Hey man, okay, I have some awesome news for you. First of all, we found some vintage audio training cassettes. Dude, these are like prehistoric. I think they were like training tapes for like other employees or something like that. So I thought we could like have them playing like over the speakers as people walk through the attraction. That makes this feel legit, man. But I have an even better surprise for you. You're not gonna believe this. We found one.
At the end of the second night, I get a massive toy Bonnie plushie.
You're doing a great job, and no doubt having a great time as well. As a reminder, please be sure to only interact with core gameplay elements and avoid anything that could potentially be considered a glitch, mistake, or embedded message from unauthorized personnel.
I then play some tapes.
Jeremy complained of nightmares when he came in this morning. He wasn't talking about it like someone telling a friend about his dreams, though. He was pale. Looked like he hadn't eaten in days. He spent an hour talking in Dale's office, but it didn't look like he was given much sympathy. When he came out, he went directly back to the testing room. He doesn't even jump anymore. Nothing scares him. He just stands there like he's talking to someone. Sometimes he rocks from side to side. We were told to leave him alone. I knew I was in line to do the testing next. They'd been prepping me for it. I guess they knew that Jeremy would need to be replaced soon.
Hello. For today's lesson, we'll be continuing our training on proper suit handling techniques. When using an animatronic as a suit, please ensure that the animatronic parts are tightly compressed and fastened by the spring lock located around the inside of the suit. It may take a few moments. Position your head and torso between these parts in a manner where you can move and speak. Try not to nudge or press against any of the spring locks inside the suit. Do not touch the spring locks at any time. Do not breathe on the spring locks, as moisture may loosen them and cause them to break loose. In case that the spring locks come loose while you are wearing a suit, please try to maneuver away from populated areas before bleeding out, as to not ruin the customer experience. As always, if there is ever an emergency, please go to the designated safe room. Every location is built with one extra room that is not included in the digital map layout program the animatronic or security team.
Hello?
Invisible to animatronics and is always off camera. As always, remember to smile and see where the face of Freddy Fazbear's teeth.
Hi. Hello? Hi.
At the end of the third night, I get a massive piece of cake.
Hello?
And at the end of the fourth night, I get some mixed nuts. And yes, I'll admit it, I did go back and try to beat the plush babies minigame again. I don't know what it is. I simply can't do it. Well, I mean, I do know what it is, I just don't know where they come from. And to end on an awesome note, I went out and checked Nightmarion minigame, which is possibly one of the scariest things in Five Nights at Freddy's VR Help Wanted. It is just so creepy to see Nightmarion slither around the bedroom. It is terrifying. And that was Five Nights at Freddy's VR Help Wanted Part 3. Again, I'm super sorry for the lack of audio. I'm gonna try my best to make sure all the other videos have audio, but of course, I am not perfect, and we all do make mistakes sometimes, even if those mistakes can ruin an entire series. So thank everyone so much for watching. Look forward to Part 4, and I'll see you all on the flip side. Goodbye.